an action. In the normal days, if you do this deed, when this person sits to do this deed, what happens? That from all four sides, the angels surround that person or those people. Allah's mercy surrounds those people or that person. Sakina, satisfaction descends on those people. Peace and happiness descends on those people. Allah sits in His heavens on the arsh, and with pride Allah Ta'ala speaks about those people who are doing this deed. So if a person doesn't do a deed in Ramadan, then he is the most unfortunate person. Isn't it? Okay, you've read Quran, you've done Nawafil, Salat, Taraweeh, but this deed about which Allah Ta'ala says, I am proud in the heavens about those people, then he is the unfortunate person who doesn't do this amal. Look, if you go around the world today, all the masjids, go to every masjid, and you will see very few people doing dhikr of Allah. Great deed. Great deed in normal days, away from Ramadan, this is the situation, the reward. And as I said, if we start, oh yeah, I'm doing tasbih, I'm doing dhikr. No, this point I'm doing is about the majlis of dhikr. Not dhikr individually. People do dhikr and read and recite, but this thawab I'm telling you about, the reward, is about the majlis, the gathering, the congregation. When you sit in a congregation of dhikr, you get this reward. Majalis of dhikr. The halaqas of dhikr. There's such a massive reward. And we've read Quran during the day. Maybe we've done other good deeds. Sadaqat and charity has been distributed. And this action we leave to sit down together to remember Allah 30, 45 minutes. What a big, big loss after Ramadan. What a big, big thing we're losing out on if we don't do this action. In the hadith it is stated, narrated, the four amal that are mentioned in the Quran. Allah's dhikr, to attain maghfirah, to ask for maghfirah, to do dua for Jannah, and to save ourselves from the hellfire. These are four deeds of Ramadan. La ilaha illa Allah, astaghfiru, wa nas'alukum, na'udhu bika minan nar. That Allah Ta'ala says, dhikr, la ilaha illallah. First and foremost, Nabi Al-Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam taught us this, that Ramadan is coming.